In this problem, we have a tilted Atwood machine, and it also includes friction at the surface that the 2 kilogram block is sliding along. I'll just make a note of that coefficient over here. Mu k is 0.2. And we're basically asked for everything you could possibly ask for in this Atwood machine. I want complete force diagrams for each moving piece. I want the normal force on the 2 kilogram block, the force of friction on the 2 kilogram block, the acceleration of the system, and the tension in the string. So we start with thorough force diagrams. Gravity, of course, is pulling straight down on that 2 kilogram block. And I may as well get a decimal approximation for mg right now. So 2 times 9.8 is 19.6 newtons. And we know it's going to be useful to decompose that into parallel and perpendicular pieces. So I do my best to draw a perpendicular there. And we also know the angle of incline turns out to be the same as this angle between the weight vector and the perpendicular to the ramp. So that's 25 degrees. This allows us to decompose the force of gravity into parallel and perpendicular components. My perpendicular piece would be a mg cosine of theta. That's 19.6 cosine of 25 degrees. Into 3 sig figs, I get 17.8 newtons for that. Now there's also a parallel component, and that's equal to the length of this little dotted line that I drew to decompose the vectors. But it's more intuitive if we just transport that vector and attach it to the mass. So that's going to be mg sine theta, 19.6 sine of 25. And I get a decimal approximation on that. And that's 8.28 newtons. Again, just keeping 3 sig figs as a convention. All right, so that takes care of the force of gravity and its components. What else is acting on the 2 kilogram block? Well, there's a string attached to it, and there's a tension in the string, and we don't know what it is. So that's called T. Next, there's a normal force pushing up perpendicular to the ramp. And because this block has no acceleration perpendicular to the ramp, so it can't jump off of it or sink into it, I know that this normal force must have the same magnitude as that force of gravity pulling perpendicular down into the ramp. So that's going to be 17.8. Finally, this block is sliding up the ramp, and it experiences a friction force opposing the direction of slipping. And I'll go ahead and just leave that as Fk right now, but I know that it's equal to mu k times the normal force. And I'll just write it down in the space provided for part C. Next, I look at the 4 kilogram hanging mass. It experiences exactly the same tension, provided the string is light and the pulley is light. And that's an unknown. And then gravity pulls straight down on it with a magnitude of mg, and that's 4 times 9.8. And that gives me 39.2 newtons. Okay, so I think we've pretty thoroughly answered part A, making a complete force diagram. And in fact, we went a little above and beyond because we've already answered part B. Give me the normal force on the 2 kilogram block. That's 17.8 newtons. And then in part C, I want the force of friction on the 2 kilogram block, and Fk is going to be mu k times the normal force. That's 0.2 times 17.8. And that gives me 3.56 newtons. And then in parts D and E, we get into the real meat of the question. How do we solve for the acceleration of the system and the tension in the string? And this comes from applying Newton's second law to each moving piece in the Atwood machine. So applying Newton's second law to the 2 kilogram mass, I'm doing an analysis parallel to the ramp. I'm going to use the actual direction of acceleration as the positive direction. So F net is going to be a positive T minus Fk minus mg sine theta. There's two forces pulling in the negative direction. And that should be equal to that mass times its acceleration. Plugging in numbers here, I have T minus my friction force, that was 3.56, minus mg sine theta, which turned out to be 8.28, is equal to ma, and the mass is 2 kilograms, and a is unknown. Then I analyze the 4 kilogram mass. So I have mg pulling down, that's the weight of that guy, minus T, that pulls in the negative direction, is equal to MA. And when I plug numbers into this, MG was 39.2, so I have 39.2 minus T equals the mass of this object that was 4 kilograms times the acceleration A. Now I have a system of two equations and two unknowns. The unknowns are T and A. And it's already set up to eliminate. So I just add the left-hand sides of the two equations, and there's a T there and a negative T there, so those are gone. I add the right-hand sides and I get a 6A. So it's a matter of crunching these numbers, 39.2 minus 3.56 minus 8.28, and that should be equal to 6A. And I get 27.36 equals 6A. So finally I arrive at my acceleration, and that turns out to be 4.56 meters per second squared. Finally, we want to get the tension in the string, and I can go back to either one of those equations in the system. It seems a little simpler to use the second equation. I'm going to add T to both sides and subtract A from both sides, and I get T is equal to 39.2 minus 4A. Into 3 sig figs, I get 21.0 newtons. And you can do a little bit of a check on your work by just verifying you get the same tension if you use the other equation. I just did it real quick and it works out to 21.0, so that's good. If you find the physics content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce over 100 new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.